The Philippine province of Sulu will go into lockdown from January 4 to 17 after the new COVID-19 variant reached nearby Sabah. To tell us more about the situation in the province, we are joined by Sulu Governor Abdul Sakurtan. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Good morning, Mr. Esguera.
Okay, so the lockdown will be from January 4 to 17. Talk to us about the details of this lockdown. What should the people expect on the ground?
First, we issued the lockdown the other day, and this is going to be January 4 up to the 17th, and it is extendable. So this is only for the purpose of securing our shores from the reported or detected and reported COVID-19 strain in Sabah, Malaysia. We consider that we are so near to Sabah, and we have gone on the air to inform our people that there's going to be a lockdown, and therefore they will have to be back before the 4th. So we are actually giving them to come back to Sulu for those who would like to be back before the 4th. Otherwise, they may have a hard time coming in until after the lockdown is over.
Okay, but do these people include those who might be also coming from Sabah or yung mga local lang?
Actually, lahat. Most especially, I mean, those coming from Sabah. In fact, we have appealed to the ATF, and more particularly to the national government and the president himself, to try to negotiate with the government of Malaysia to suspend sending back of Filipinos in Sabah.
Okay, but how strict in the meantime, because this will take effect on January 4, right? But in the meantime, how strict will the screening be, especially for people coming from Sabah, going back to your province?
At the moment, we do not allow anymore. We have already advised our Sambuanga office or our Sambuanga satellite office that we are not accepting returned Filipinos from, especially from Sabah.
Okay, how about those coming from other provinces?
Coming from other provinces before the 4th, they may come, provided, however, that they secure requirements such as a health certification, medical certificate, with clearance from the task force, Sulu Task Force COVID-19.
And I suppose you will be requiring negative PCR tests, right? But how recent should the tests be?
It should be no more than 5 days from their travel coming to Sulu.
Okay. Now, once the lockdown takes effect, talk to us about the expected situation within the province. By the way, what is the quarantine classification so far in the province?
Come again, please.
Basically, what is the current quarantine or community quarantine classification in Sulu?
We are under MGCQ. So
MGCQ.
We are extending the same status of Sulu under MGCQ, and therefore we follow whatever is the guidelines and protocols under MGCQ, except that we wrote a letter addressed to Secretary Galvez and members of the IATF, Secretary Lorenzana, Secretary Galvez, Secretary Duque, Secretary Año, that we may have to take measures that we deem necessary for the purpose of preventing the new strain from coming in into our shores.
Okay, and so far, how many do you have any COVID cases now?
At the moment, we only have 2 COVID cases. All the rest have already recovered, with only 12 deaths.
12 deaths, right?
Yes, sir.
So during the peak, how many were infected in your province?
All in all, there were 242.
242. Okay.
Yes.
Now, give us an idea of how porous the borders of Sulu are. That's why it's very important to impose a very strict lockdown if you are to prevent the entry of this new SARS-CoV-2 variant to your province. I mean, normally.
Well, Sulu is an island province, and the mainland of Sulu is constituted by 11 mainland municipalities with 8 island municipalities, and these are all surrounded by sea. So consider also the vast Sulu Sea, which extends even beyond the border between Sulu and Sabah. So although Sabah is so clear, so close to us.
Okay, so how are you going to strictly enforce the lockdown given the porous borders of your province?
We have requested, I sat down with General Command, Commander Lieutenant General Vinluan, together with the 11th Infantry Division, Commander General Gonzalez, and they, we all agreed that we need additional assets, and therefore we requested the national government to provide some more assets, especially water assets, such as watercrafts for the Philippine Coast Guard and Philippine National Police Maritime, as well as, of course, the Philippine Navy. And if possible, if they could provide us with choppers that would monitor the borders.
That is quite a lot of assets. How many of them have been made available by the national government?
At the moment, we have some assets, but they may not be enough. And therefore, we are also mobilizing barangay officials, the municipal officials and the barangay officials, to do their part in securing our shores.
Okay, now in terms of the systems in place, talk to us about that. Because in other areas, there's a QR code involved, right, in the system to make sure that everyone that comes in and out of a particular area are strictly monitored. Do you have something similar in your province?
Yes,
sir. For visitors, yeah.
For visitors, we only allow them, provided that they have PCR test. And they can only stay for so many days, 3 days. And beyond that, they will have to leave. And of course, another is we have a lot of tracers, contact tracers in every municipality. So we really do not have a hard time monitoring, especially those suspected to have been infected with this COVID.
And how many quarantine facilities do you have available?
We have a lot of quarantine facilities available in every municipality, and in fact, in several of our barangays have facilities for the purpose of putting people in quarantine.
Are you also strictly implementing the no face mask and no face shield policy in Sulu when people go out in public?
Yes, we do, especially those riders and mga angkas, they would need face shield. But those who are not in public transport, they may just use face mask. But those in public transport, they will have to, of course, maintain distancing and wear face shields.
Okay. Governor Sakurtan, thank you for joining us, and Happy New Year, sir.
Thank you, sir, and Happy New Year too.